The evidence is clear. Across industries, across cultures, there are three fundamental styles of interaction. I want to get you thinking about what is your style and what are the implications of that for your work, for your life, and for your success in achieving your goals. I call them reciprocity styles. For me, a style of reciprocity is your mindset, your habit, when you're interacting with someone else to exchange something of value. What are you trying to accomplish? On one end of the spectrum, we have people that I call takers. People who are always trying to get as much as possible from others, never want to give anything back unless they absolutely have to. If you've ever worked with a taker, you will have learned an important skill like social loafing, also known as free riding or shirking, which involves the taker saying, I will not participate in this project unless it's important, interesting, or visible. And yet, despite everyone else doing all the grunt work, I will somehow walk away with the majority of credit for this collective accomplishment. On the other end of the spectrum, we have these odd people that I'm going to call givers. And for me, a giver is not a philanthropist. A giver is not a volunteer. Rather, if you are a giver, you're somebody who enjoys helping others and often does it without strings attached. That might involve sharing your knowledge, teaching your skills, being a mentor. Perhaps something as simple as making an introduction or just being somebody who shows up early or stays late to try to support the people around you. Now, I find, though, that it's pretty rare for any of us to be pure givers in all of our interactions. Right? You might have moments of giving, like when you're mentoring, not really thinking about what can I get back from this person, just focusing on how can I help them develop and grow. You also probably have moments of taking, like the last time you negotiated your salary. My guess is the focus was more on what can I get than what I can contribute. What I find, though, is that most of us, in the majority of our interactions, hover right in the middle of that spectrum, between givers and takers. And that's a third style that I call being a matcher. If you're a matcher, you are trying to keep an even balance of give and take in every interaction you have. Quid pro quo. So if I were a matcher and I were to do you a favor, I would expect an equal one in return. And if you were to do me a favor, I'd feel like I was in debt until I'd settled the score. Being a matcher is basically like being an accountant in all of your interpersonal relationships. Keeping track of credits and debits and making sure that everything always lines up perfectly. And it seems like a safe way to live your professional life. What I wanted to know, though, was, is that the most productive and effective way to live your professional life? And just as a preview, the answer to that question is going to be a definitive maybe. Now, I know that in every audience, people are wondering, what is my style? How do I know if I'm a giver, a taker, or a matcher? So like any self-respecting psychologist, I have prepared a test, and I would love for all of you to take it now.